Welcome friends, today we are going to discuss complexation and drug action, how this complexation affects drug action, then thermodynamic treatment of a stability constant of the particular complexation process. First of all, we'll discuss how complexation affects the drug action. Complexation can alter pharmacological activity of the agents by inhibiting interaction with these receptors. They are interfere binding of your drug with the receptors, and because of this pharmacological activity will be changed or will be increased or decreased. Then action of drug to remove toxic metal ions from human body each through complexation reaction. Now in case of metal poisoning, what happen? These complexing agents are prescribed, and that complexing agent is having the ability to form a complex with that particular metal, and by using such type of the complexing agents, metals removed from your body. In some instances, complexation can also lead to poor solubility or decreased absorption of drug in the body. If your individual drug is having a very good solubility and your complex form is having a less solubility, then ultimately your complexation process decreases solubility and decreases its absorption into the gastrointestinal tract. Then aqueous solubility of tetracycline decreases substantially when it complexes with calcium ion, or co-administration of calcium along with this tetracycline decreases this solubility of tetracycline. Some antacid formulations consist of calcium, and when you administer this antacid along with this tetracycline, there might be the chances of complexation of this calcium with tetracycline, and it decreases solubility of tetracycline and ultimately decreases absorption of this tetracycline into the body. Drug complexation with hydrophilic compounds also can enhance excretion. Sometimes final complex is having a very good solubility, so it can be easily eliminated through the excretion process, and the complex is having a hydrophilic nature, that's why it is easily excreted. Now we'll see different examples of drugs. Cisplatin and carboplatin are platinum complexes too, and that complexes have proved to be a most useful agent in the treatment of cancer, and this is a coordination compound. Cisplatin as well as carboplatin, they are in the form of complexes with platinum, and they are used into the treatment of cancer. Then povidone iodine, all of you quite familiar about this compound, used in the treatment of wound. This compound is a complex polyvinyl pyrrolidone, is a water soluble polymer and form a water soluble complex with this iodine, and that formulation or product is known as povidone iodine. A complex is soluble in water. Drug can be removed easily from application site. It has an antibacterial action. Then complexation of drug in a gastrointestinal tract fluid alter rate and extent of drug absorption. Again, calcium plus tetracycline decreases absorption of tetracycline. Then PMC plus amphetamine, that complex is also having a less solubility, less absorption. When you administered polar drug along with this complexing agent, this polar drug will be absorbed well. Thermodynamic Now this is all about how complexation affects pharmacological activity and drug action. Now we'll discuss stability constant, how this stability constant is affected by change into the temperature. Stability constant means it is the ratio of your product divided by reactant during this complexation process. This relationship between standard free change of complexation and overall stability constant K can be given by following equation, that is delta G is equal to 2.303 RT into log K. K is nothing but stability constant of that particular complexation process. Then standard enthalpy change is delta H, may be obtained from slope of graph of plot of log K versus 1 by T. Okay, when you plot the graph of stability constant versus 1 by T, 1 upon temperature, then slope of that graph will be value of your enthalpy change or standard enthalpy change. Now we can rearrange this we can put this equation log K is equal to negative delta H upon 2.303 into 1 upon T plus constant. When values of K at a 2 temperature are known, then following equation may be used, like log K2 upon K1 is equal to negative delta H divided by 2.303 R T2 minus T1 divided by T1 into T2. It means if you take a value of this K at two different temperature, then your equation will be modified. The standard entropy change may be obtained from following expression, that is delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. Now this stability constant for molecular complexation increases, delta H and delta S generally become more negative. When this value of delta G is negative, then your complexation process rate will be high. For that purpose, you required less value for your temperature and delta H, then it will become negative. Your delta G will become more negative and your complexation rate will be high. But when this delta G value is positive, then rate of complexation will be decreased. As a binding between this donor acceptor becomes stronger, then this delta H also become more negative. Since the specificity of interacting species or structural restraint also become negative, delta S also become more negative. However, the extent of change of this delta H is very enough to overcome a favorable entropy change resulting in a negative G. This value of your enthalpy, that is delta H, should be like that value of your delta G will become negative and ultimately it increases complexation. Now one more thing, this equation also consists of temperature. Now this temperature, at a higher temperature, what happened, this whole value become high. then when this value become high as that of your delta H, value of your G will become negative. And rate of your complexation is high at a negative G value. Okay, this is all about complexation and drug action and thermodynamics of this stability constant. Thank you for watching.